So I believe we have some time for questions. I'll be very happy to answer any questions people have. And I think there's some roving microphones that will go around to make sure everyone can hear you.
When was the last time like a man supposedly landed on the moon?
I like your use of the word supposedly there. 1972, as I recall, I was about 4 years old, and in fact it is one of the earliest things I remember. I'm not quite sure what I made of it, watching hours of television as these astronauts bounded across the moon's surface, but nonetheless, although I don't remember the first landing, I do remember the last one. It was Apollo 17. There were several more missions planned, but due to budget cuts, they didn't take place. So it's getting on for 39 years since the last person set foot on the moon. We have a question down here.
Where do you get your materials and how do you do research? Like, is it now publicly available? All information about the mission, is it available?
Absolutely. I can certainly point you towards the NASA website, but what I've recognized is that, frankly, these days there's so much information available, it's hard for people to sort out what's useful and what isn't. So what I've set out to do with this webpage here is to collect together some useful resources and starting points. It's not to say that's the definitive information and you need look nowhere else. It's just to be a good launch-off point for you to find other things. So from this webpage, designed to be a launch-off point for all the schools who've undertaken this as a science project, what it takes you to is some NASA webpages, some other webpages which have looked at all of these conspiracy theories and systematically tried to address them, develop projects to study them. So, you know, this one webpage, I would contend, should give you plenty of further launch-off points to then explore it more thoroughly. And all the video clips that I've showed, including the ones I didn't have time to show, they're all there on this webpage too. So have a look, see what you think, and make up your own minds. Any more questions? It's hard for me to see, which sort of rather proves the point about the bright light sources you see. Yeah, I think we have a question down here.
Hi, I was just wondering, given that everything that's pretty useful to humanity is mind, do they know much about what's going on underneath the surface of the moon?
Oh, certainly, and indeed, in the longer term, I think that would be by far the strongest economic case for a return to the moon, would be to mine the mineral resources present there. But basically, most of the cost and most of the effort in getting the Apollo astronauts to the moon was getting them off the ground in the first place. The Saturn V moon rocket, by far the most powerful rocket we've ever launched, most of the fuel was just to go those first few dozen miles above the Earth's surface. So the chief challenge for the successful exploitation of the resources the moon has is how you can cheaply get it back. Now, my part of the world, growing up in the 70s, what we saw was a huge investment in North Sea oil. That also was extremely costly and very difficult and challenging. But there came a point where we needed the oil so much, it was worthwhile making that investment to extract it from an inaccessible location. I think eventually that will happen with the moon, but we're maybe a few decades off that point because there's still plenty of places on Earth where you can access those material resources as well. But I'm an amateur economist when it comes to these matters, but as far as I can see, if there's a demand for something at a sufficient level, then we will do it. Well, if there are no more questions, maybe I can leave you with one of my own, which is to see whether we still have anyone who thinks maybe we didn't land on the moon, or have I managed to change any minds. Okay, mission accomplished, I think, as somebody said from a podium a few years ago. Thank you very much again, and I do encourage you to have a look at some of the resources, think about it for yourselves, and by all means keep in touch, let me know what you discover. And I look forward to maybe meeting you again some point in the future. Thank you. Bye-bye.